Now we are going to take a few numericals based on the Planck's quantum theory as well as the photoelectric effect. So here we start. The first question we have is, calculate frequency, that means you need to find the nu, and energy of the photon having wavelength 6000 angstrom. So that means you are provided with the wavelength. So we know that to find the frequency, we have the relation between wavelength and frequency. Nu is equal to C over lambda. So here the lambda, if we convert into meter unit, it comes out to be 6000 into 10 raised to power minus 10 meters. So nu is equal to C over lambda. So putting values, C is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 and wavelength is 6000 into 10 raised to power minus 10. So when you solve for it, you'll get an answer equal to 5 into 10 raised to power 14 hertz. Right, so this is how you'll find the nu. And we did this kind of numericals in the electromagnetic spectrum also. But look at the second part. We need to find the energy of the photon. We know that photon is linked with the Planck's quantum theory. And energy of photon is calculated by E is equal to h nu. We have nu, so putting value, h we know that it is Planck's constant, 6.6 into 10 raised to power minus 34. Nu we have is 5 into 10 raised to power 14, already calculated. So when you'll multiply the figures, you'll get 3.3 into 10 raised to power minus 19 joules. I'm writing the answer direct because you are aware of the multiplication and division or the mathematical operators what we use. So here what I want to explain you is that how to manipulate the formulas and how to use them and how to remember, and please do remember the units values also, that like the constant values like h is here, used here. So you should be aware of the h, Planck's constant value also, because sometimes you will get, sometimes you won't get. So you need to remember it. Second question is, we need to find the energy of 1 mole of photons having frequency this. So we need to find the energy of 1 mole of photon. So the first step is that we know that we find energy by formula E is equal to h nu. But here we need to find for 1 mole of photons. So it is better to find for one photon first. So putting values, Planck's constant we already know, 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34. Nu is given, unit is okay, 5 into 10 raised to power 14. So this is the energy possessed by one photon. But you have been asked for the 1 mole. So when you will solve for the 1 mole, you know that 1 mole contains 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 entities. Like here it is photons. So let's say it is this number of photons present. So when you will multiply the figures, you are going to get an answer equal to 19951 joule per mole, and you can also convert into kilojoules also by dividing it with 1000. So if you need to derive an answer in kilojoules, it will be probably 9.951 kilojoules per mole. Right, so this is how you're going to take up the question based like this. Third we have is, a 100 watt bulb, that means power is 100 watt, it emits light of wavelength 400 nanometer. So wavelength emitted is 400 nanometers. We need to find number of photons emitted per second. So how we find this? See, number of photons emitted is found by a formula, total energy upon energy of one photon. So kindly remember this. When you need to find number of photons which are emitted, you need to have a ratio between the total energy divided by the energy of one photon. So it's time to calculate first total energy first. So as the power is 100 watt, so that means it can be written as 100 joule per second. So total energy is 100 joule per second. You need to find energy of one photon. This is wavelength. And when we convert in a meter, it becomes 400 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 meter. And we know that E is equal to h nu. We can also write E is equal to hc over lambda also, because nu is equal to c over lambda. Putting values, we have E is equal to h is 6.6 into 10 raised to power minus 34. C, you know, is the speed of light. Lambda is 400 into 10 raised to power minus 9. So when you will solve it, you will get an answer equal to 4.969 into 10 raised to power minus 19 joules. So now we need to find number of photons emitted. So we need to have a ratio between the total energy. Total energy is 100 joule per second divided by the energy of one photon, 4.969 into 10 raised to power minus 19. So if you will divide this 100 by 4.969 into 10 to the power minus 9, the answer you are going to get is 2.012 into 10 raised to the power 20. So these are the number of, you can say, the photons that is being emitted when number of photons emitted in this much of light. Next we have is calculate kinetic energy of electron. This is based on the ejection phenomena, that is the photoelectric effect. We need to find the energy of the kinetic energy of the electron ejected when this light falls with frequency this and on the potassium metal surface, and work function, or you can say threshold frequency, is being this. You know that Bohr actually explained, Planck's quantum theory actually explained it, that for the ejection, the total energy which falls on the surface is equal to binding energy plus kinetic energy. This you know that. And E we know is equal to h nu, binding energy is equal to h nu naught, and kinetic energy we know is half mv square. Here we are asked to find the kinetic energy. So let us not use the formula, let us just write the kinetic energy. So when you need to find kinetic energy, just this thing, changing their position, we have h nu minus h nu naught, right, substituting their value. H we know, we can take the H common also. Nu minus nu naught is going to equal to kinetic energy. So putting the values, H we have is 6.6 into 10 raised to power minus 34. Nu is 5.2 into 10 raised to power 14. And nu naught is 5 into 10 raised to power 14. So when you will solve it, you will probably get an answer equal to 1.325 into 10 raised to power minus 20 as a kinetic energy meter per second. So this is how you're going to solve the question. Just you need to use the relation which has already been explained when we did a theoretical process. So this is all about the numericals based on the Planck's quantum theory as well as on the photoelectric effect, or the phenomena which are actually explained on the basis of Planck's quantum theory.